Very well. How are you, Dusty? Don't do anything stupid out there.
Hope you're finding everything you need.
If you don't see what you want, feel free to ask. Oh, please, take a look. Thanks for coming in.
Ship, you've entered Freestar Collective space. Maintain your current course while we scan for contraband. Scan complete. Go ahead and land.
Yeah. listening.
Appreciate the lift. And once we touch down in Aquila, we'll talk more.
How have you been? Need a hand? Goodbye.
Hi. Please disregard. I attempted an informal greeting, but I am dissatisfied with the results. Captain, greetings. I am relieved you have given up on carrying everything yourself. Farewell.
Pardon my ignorance. We just didn't expect to find people out here. We didn't think anyone else left Earth before us.
Perhaps we should greet our guests.
Of course. Manners. I'm Captain Diana Brackenridge. This is Security Officer Bomani Reeder. And this is Dr. Mabuti Da Costa, one of our elders.
A pleasure to meet you.
I see. As you may have presumed, we're in a bit of a bind. Our ship has finally completed its near 200-year journey from Earth, only to find our new home seemingly colonized by... well, we don't know. Communications haven't been successful, so your arrival is fortuitous. Perhaps you'd be willing to act as a middle person between ourselves and... the others. Well, the short answer is, we didn't. It's a generation ship, which is to say that most of us lived long, happy lives on board and passed our mission down to our children. It was never intended that the original crew would make it to our destination. The goal was always the preservation, though it would seem that was perhaps a bit presumptuous. We're not entirely sure. Our engineers believe it's possible that our technology just isn't compatible with theirs. All we hear when using them to communicate with anyone is a bunch of disturbing noise. It gave me the heebie-jeebies at first. Oh yes, of course. Where are my manners? Now then, please follow me. There's much to discuss first. We'll speak more on the matter once we reach the bridge. Dr. Da Costa, you may return to your quarters if you wish.
Thank you, Captain.
I will follow you to the bridge, ma'am. For security purposes.
The Constant is a peaceful
ship. I do not
ship.
Think we have need to fear our
Don't
men,
change
but
that.
Our
we were never trained to address
Welcome
threats
to the
coming
Earth
from outside our ship.
Constant. In the early 2100s, my ancestor, Rupert Brackenridge, researched a number of scientific scenarios. Climate change, asteroid impact... Within 50 years, he fully believed Earth was destined to be rendered uninhabitable. We've always assumed that's what happened. So, he gathered the best and brightest he could find, built the Constant, and set a course for this planet here. We were told that it was the largest, most advanced ship ever constructed on Earth at the time. If you can believe, entire generations have been born, lived, and died on this ship. It really goes to show that there are no limits to human ingenuity and perseverance. anyone would be out here, but I'm glad for it. A bit frazzled, as you can imagine. People are anxious about discovering that we're not alone, and also worried about what will come to pass. While we hope we can work out a deal with the people on the surface, they seem reluctant to reach out, so there's no telling what will come of that. I do know that we can't afford to stay here in orbit forever. The ship was built to sustain us for many years with backup provisions just in case, but even that will come to an end eventually. Difficult is the wrong word. It can be both challenging at times and also exciting. Our mission was to rebuild humanity on a distant world, believing that we were Earth's last hope. To think that while there has always been a Brackenridge in the captain's chair, that I am the one to finally oversee our journey's end is truly exhilarating. But with this stumbling block in our path, at this final moment, I fear tough choices will need to be made. Well, as I mentioned, we've been unsuccessful in communications with anyone up until you arrived, though not for lack of trying. But since you're asking, maybe you'd be willing to be a sort of diplomat between us and them as we attempt to resolve our situation. Does that sound agreeable to you? No, not at all. We simply have no other options. With no working communications and no way to head to the surface, we need outside help negotiating with the settlement we've spotted below. You see, we intended to settle here, but we assume that they intend to defend their claim given their presence here. We'd like you to go speak to them on our behalf and help us negotiate a solution, preferably one that favors us. Based on the data our ancestors had when they launched this endeavor, it was determined that this was the perfect planet for us. Even if we had another viable candidate planet, we lacked the resources to get there. And as you know, it took us 200 years to get here. Our people have no desire to go back to drifting the stars so their children's children can possibly settle on an inferior planet. Yes, yes, of course. But we need to start from a firm position and state our goal. If need be, we can compromise, work out a mutually beneficial deal or some such, but initially I'd like you to be firm with them and convince them to leave the planet to us. Let me know how they respond, and we'll go from there. Now, it makes little sense to give up before you try. Thank you. And good luck.
Now that we know what's out there, things are going to be more interesting from here on out.
Never seen a ship like yours before.
Just because our equipment's old, doesn't mean it won't work to take down troublemakers. Careful waving that fancy gun around. We don't need to see what it can do.
We've got strict rules around here, but they're strict for a reason.
These are exciting times, aren't they?
I've spent my entire life in a constant. I'm not sure how else to live.
tribe out there beyond our little community.
We've got strict rules around here. They're strict for a reason.
Miss Julia.
Careful waving that fancy gun around.
Just stay out of trouble.
Got something for me?
How can I be of service, Captain? Good day, Captain. Am I currently in possession of an item you require? See you at a later time.
Hello, And welcome back, Mr. Tofu. Resort. Your repeat patronage is much appreciated. Is there any assistance I may offer you today?
Actually, a question. Usually when I come here...
Enjoy your stay, knowing you're in our capable hands.
You'd think we'd be a prime target for pirates. But they know to stay away for the most part. Don't worry about us. We're just here to keep the peace.
Welcome to Paradiso. Jiro Tsukiyama at your service. Do you have a security concern, or is there something else I can help you with? Neither. We're our own private force. The Paradiso Group pays top dollar for top-notch security. And I dare say we're some of the best in the business. We have to be out here on the fringes of the settled systems. Honestly, it's not as exciting as you might think most of the time. More often than not, we're just handling drunk and disorderly conduct. Heck, even pirates leave us alone for the most part. I think it's because some of them actually vacation here. As long as they're not bothering anyone, we've been told not to worry about them.
Something I can help you with?
Oh, it has a name. Good. Then you're already familiar with the situation, I take it. Do you know what they want? Interesting. We obviously have no records of a colony ship claiming this planet. Whatever the case, you'll need to speak with Oliver Campbell, a CEO for the Paradiso Group. He's in charge of bringing all formal decisions before the board and helping to make calls on them. I'll let him know you're on your way.
Paradise, but that doesn't mean we don't run into trouble from time to time.
Beautiful out there, isn't it?
Paradiso security is only here for your safety. Pretend we're not even here.
Hey there.
Please, let the concierge know if you need anything. Hello there.
Your safety is our number one priority.
Excuse me, you can't just waltz in there. Do you have an appointment? Oh, you're the one they're waiting for then. Do you need anything else from me before you meet with the board? What I could tell you would get me in a lot of trouble. Most of them are typical C-level execs. I doubt you even need to use your imagination for that. The ones that show up to work day to day, at least. I swear, I've never even met some of them, because they chill at their own private secluded beach homes all the time. Anyway, be smart around Oliver. He's got a way of getting what he wants without you realizing it. And that's all I'll say. I can't speak for anyone else, but I've got a pretty high-pressure job working as the executive assistant to the Paradiso board. You can imagine, dealing with a team of execs, trying to manage all of their schedules and their other whims. But it pays well, and they give me a nice executive suite at the hotel to live in. So, it's not all bad. Free access to all the resort's amenities after work helps, too. Sure. Have fun in the Shark Tank. And don't worry, even they call it that.
I just feel that we should be focusing on the natural beauty of this planet, not our amenities.
There are millions of planets out there. People can go to any one of them. The resort facilities are precisely what we bring to the table. Heck, it's the only thing we've really got to offer.
I don't want to risk us coming off as just another artificial, shady, trash-filled dump like Neon. That's not who we are. We've got something special here. We should embrace that.
Belong's right.
Thank you.
We don't want to compete with Neon. Bayou's ruthless. He'll do anything he can to eliminate the competition. We don't need that kind of trouble. That being said, I think there's a middle ground. Maybe build up the beachfront in a boardwalk amusement park. I've had this idea to build artificial hot springs, that sort of thing.
Sounds good. I'll look into what that will cost us and we can circle back around to this.
If you've heard about us elsewhere, chances are... it's because of me.
I'll make some time for you, but keep it quick, yeah? Hello? I didn't realize Kiwi was letting people in here. Not quite. We just don't answer to the Free Star Collective or the United Colonies. Makes things easier. We don't pay any taxes. We don't need to follow their laws. All the benefits, none of the drawbacks. And no one minds, because half the politicians and other big shots love vacationing here. Works for everyone. No, of course not. There's several more. We're just the ones who show up day to day. The others spend their time lazing on the beach, gallivanting off-world. Doesn't bother me, though. Less cooks in the kitchen means I get to make all the big decisions around here. Seems to be working out for us just fine. We, the Paradiso Group, bought the rights to this planet years ago with the intent of turning it into the biggest and best resort in the universe. To that end, I'd say we've succeeded. As such, no other leisure enterprises may operate on the planet without renting land from us. But as you can see, none can afford such a deal. I am. And you must be the diplomat Jiro told me about. Welcome, welcome. Normally I'd offer you an all-inclusive stay at our resort before we spoke. But given the circumstances, I'm going to cut to the chase. We've got our friends, the aliens, up there causing all sorts of problems for our resort. You like that? The marketing team came up with it. The thought is, if we can't get rid of them, it might actually attract more tourism. Come see the aliens! We We run a premier resort getaway here. We can't have our guests concocting stories about some bodgy old ship hanging around up there. As it is, we've had to reroute our luxury liners around the other side of the planet on entry so no one sees it. It's bad for business. We need to nip this in the bud and take care of it before the tourists catch on and cause a scene. Ah, we're being direct then. Good on ya. So, what do you know about this dodgy ship I'm hearing all about? Well, that's something. Shame we can't just tell them kindly to bugger off. Something tells me that's not going to work. Now, tell me, what are we going to do about it? Give me some proposals, people. I need something to work with here.
We could offer to resettle them here. There's more than enough space.
They could stay here, temporarily. But it'll cost them quite a bit, too. They'd need to work off all their debts before being allowed to leave.
Maybe not. What if we help them get out of here? Outfit their ship with a grav drive so they can find a new home. We could even lend our engineers to help and give their captain an updated star map. What do you think?
Sounds costly. We can't absorb that cost, and it's unlikely they even have compatible currency, let alone enough for the transaction. Someone else would have to foot the bill.
Oh, I swear this would be a lot easier if they ceased to exist entirely. Anyway, Seema's got the right idea. Either works for me. Just tell me what you want to do. We own this planet. They don't. Here at Paradiso, we don't like leaving things to chance. Who knows what these people will do with their land? Imagine the landscaping disasters they might come up with, and how that might mar the satellite imagery of the planet in our brochures. No, much better to assimilate them into our culture if they come here to live, rather than leave it to chance. And that's within your right. But as the CEO of Paradiso Group, I'm the one who has to make and approve decisions around here, not you. So, as much as I appreciate your feedback, it's not in the best interest of the Paradiso Group to take it into account. And which proposal will you be taking to the good captain? I assume there's a captain? Right. Assuming they agree to the terms, I've got a list of resources you'll need to gather and bring back so we can support the new arrivals. We'll need to improve our lodging and infrastructure, plus account for future projects to support an increased population. Don't care how you procure them, just make sure to bring them here with you before we can consider this a done deal. Right. On behalf of the Paradiso Group, we appreciate your help. I believe our arrangement with the colonists will work out in the long run. Go on now. Enjoy Paradiso.
can I help you with?
Let's put this bird into space. Aimpoint reached. Orbit stable.
Finally give my crew a chance at a new life. What's the good word? That doesn't sound so bad. My crew will need to get used to working for a living anyway. This seems agreeable. Is that all? I'm not sure what we can spare. Unfortunately, we just don't have any resources to spare. As you can imagine, our ancestors were not able to bring many excess supplies. Certainly not. But you must understand that you worked out this deal, not us. We had no idea we would need to gather and donate such things. And I'm telling you that I'm not sure we can spare anything at this point. Sorry, we can't spare more now. If we can find some other way of repaying you, we will. Thank you. Don't forget to tell of us in your travels.
Just because our equipment's old doesn't mean it won't work to take down troublemakers.
I know I'm getting up there in years, but I don't think I'll ever tire.
Now that we know what's out there, is it going to be more interesting? We've got strict rules around here.
Just stay out of trouble.
Thank you.
All green on release. We're free to fly.
Yes? Have something for me? Time to go? Until later.
You! This here is our mind. So you can get the hell out or we'll kill you. The lair of the Mantis is ours. Five. Four. Get the hell out now. Three, two, oh, it's on!
Let me see what you...
Glad to see you're back in one piece. Let's get this done and keep moving. Best of luck out there. I'll take that from you.
Mining on the schedule today?
Don't get too far ahead.
Thank you.
Well, I like that attitude.
teams, we scared them off.
Get some cover! Watch
out! I've met plenty of rocks tougher than you!
Mm-hmm.
room in my bag if something needs carrying. I'll see you later.
Thank you.
don't load us both down with too much. So long, Dusty.
Thank you.
sorry I could never show this lair to you. The lair is a secret that's been passed down for over 100 years. And there are rules. You remember when you were a teenager? All the training, the drills, all of it was to prepare you for this. I know you have it in you, Leon.
here is slowing us down. We should leave some stuff behind.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
What do you need me to take? Come back soon.
Shields are gone. Take them out.
Can I help?
Down. Let me take some things.